Hey guys, something that's worth knowing and tracking over time is your body fat percentage. That is the proportion of your total body mass that is made up of fat. There are many different ways this can be measured, but two methods in particular are best suited to tracking over time. The first of these is using body fat scales. Their technical name is bioelectrical impedance. That's because they send tiny electrical impulses through your body. Those impulses travel slower through fat compared to lean muscle, and so the scales can use that information to work out your body fat percentage. The simplest versions have four touch points, two on each foot, but you'll see some scales include hand electrodes that offer additional points of contact. Other than not using them directly after exercise or eating, the main consideration to be aware of is your hydration level. The more water you have in your system, the faster those electrical impulses travel and the lower it will report your body fat to be. Luckily, in my experience at least, I found this to be a very linear relationship. This is 4 years of data, so my body fat will have varied within that time. You can hopefully see the relationship between my total body water percentage, a figure that most scales will provide, and body fat percentage. A healthy range for total body water is 50 to 65% for men and 45 to 60% for women. Based on those numbers, I've assumed that the midpoint is the best approximation of my true body fat percentage, which would mean I'm around 16.5% fat. My recommendation is to calibrate the scales yourself over the course of a few days. Your true body fat percentage likely won't fluctuate much in that time, but your hydration status will. At the very least, you could measure yourself twice, once when you're quite dehydrated, perhaps first thing in the morning, and then again when you're hydrated. I asked my wife to measure herself three times at different levels of hydration across the same day, almost an identical relationship to mine, around 1% body fat for every 1% total body water. A set of body fat scales can be purchased for under £100, but I can appreciate some people don't want to spend that, so the second method is free. While there will be individual variation in how fat is distributed across the body, seeing someone's stomach is a relatively good indication of their body fat percentage. Plenty of websites have created visual reference charts showing a broad range of body fat percentages. You can see dozens of examples if you search for body fat percentage in Google Images. I'm going to show some nicely presented ones from ultimateperformance.com. Starting with the men, you can see everything from 8% right up to 40%. Remember, when trying to find your place on this chart, you could be between two images. My scales tell me I'm 16.5% body fat. If I try to match the strong lighting in the pictures, you can see my chest and torso is a little less defined than the 15% guy, but better than 20%. So 17 to 18% seems fair. With women, you have the added factor of cup size, but again, there are clear differences between each picture. And again, you may be halfway between two. If you're wanting to track over time, the easiest thing you can do is to take pictures of yourself under the same lighting conditions at the same time of day and then compare over time. I did this for a fat loss video. Excuse the tattoo, it has since been removed. Over the course of 10 weeks, I lost 3 kilos, and it's hopefully obvious from my abdominal region that I reduced my body fat percentage as well. In terms of what a good body fat percentage is to aim for, here are the ranges that you'll typically see quoted online. There is a level of essential fat below which your health will really start to deteriorate. That's what bodybuilders might reach on the one day that they're on stage. Otherwise, you can see the ranges for an athletic physique, a good physique, then what would be considered average, and finally, what might be labelled overweight or obese. Bear in mind, for health, there are other factors that matter, like the distribution of that fat. Abdominal fat, in particular visceral fat, the internal fat that sits around your organs, is much worse for your health. It's worth taking additional things like your waist measurement in order to build a more complete picture of your health. Thanks for watching.